Hello, we're Ward Thomas, and this is Restless Voices.
Put your hand in my hand and help me see it's not just me.
600,000 songs are put up a week on Spotify.
How many songs?
600,000.
600,000 songs.
That's what's so great about Spotify. There is obviously so many pros and cons about it, like the streaming world, it's brought some new challenges in the music industry, but it's also given people an easy, you know, up and coming artists and songwriters and a platform for people to put their music on, which is so, so refreshing.
Yeah.
I mean, we've got so many songs that we haven't put on the album. We've written so many that we'd love to release on, like, separately on Spotify, and to be able to do that is great.
Yeah. It is amazing.
Well, have you had any sessions that you're just like really excited about, even if
yes, War Thomas.
Oh, well, good. Oh, no. Good.
Okay. Six tracks. No, just lots of new kind of singer songwritery stuff, lots of pop stuff. Yeah, just the usual.
Yeah, it's a funny one. It's always because
you're
in with new people every day.
You guys are so humble because you are doing so well, and you're both like, "Oh, I don't know." But you guys have got loads of stuff up.
Ed has done pretty much every pop amazing stuff about the last 7 years. Every song you'll love, he's written. Check him. Just type in his name.
Well, it is weird though, isn't it? Because your days are full of just new people every day. I find those are the scariest sessions.
Yeah.
Where you're like,
I find
that. Do you ever look at your diary and see that it's with each other and you're like, oh, thank God.
Yeah.
I've got a week of just hanging out with my mates. But when it's a week of new people, you're like,
because they sometimes don't work.
What if they're mean to me?
I find that terrifying as well. Like,
it's horrible. There's always a dynamic to a room.
There's the dominant, We can say that off camera, but anyway. But there's a different dynamic.
Yeah.
Rachel taught us the whole analogy and how you have to be able to be both.
Can I explain it?
To be both.
You've got
to
look.
The one that massages the ego of the dominant.
Yeah.
Or the one that's quite happy being the dominant and less
being massaged.
Yeah. 100%. And here's the thing. If I walk into a room and I see someone they are, for me, the dominant or the non.
It's a dick and the fluffer, basically.
Yeah.
We'll just say it out loud.
How you said it.
They're the organ to be manipulated.
Yeah.
Then I will be there and I will manipulate it.
But also making everyone feel like welcome in a room as well.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
even if someone's
like tea and biscuits, so important.
if someone's not coming up with anything or they're having an off day, like it's about making them feel
okay. That's okay as well.
Like, yeah. What do you think about this? It's involving people.
Yeah. And sometimes I've had a day where I felt like I had no ideas, and then you leave the room thinking, oh, they probably think I'm useless.
But no, they never write.
But it's like every experienced songwriter has also had those days, you know, where I've like sat there being like, I'm useless.
But that's when you learn how to, like, find your safe place in the room.
Yeah.
You know, how
go off other people's.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for coming on our show. You are officially our first ever Restless Voices guest.
Yeah,
Ed
thanks Drew for having us.
And Rachel Ferner, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you so much for watching, and keep an eye out for the next episode.
There's episodes now.